In this tutorial, we are going to discuss how to prepare samples for gelatin zymography. An important thing to keep in mind is that MMPs, which are the proteins that we are trying to measure using this technique, are able to activate and degrade themselves. So, to prevent your samples from changing over time, it's important to keep them either frozen at negative 80 degrees Celsius or on ice from the time you collect them until you try to measure their activity. MMPs can be measured from a number of sources, including culture media samples, cells, and tissue lysates. I'm going to share a few tips for each of these sample types. Media samples. Media samples are the most straightforward to collect. Simply remove the media from your cell culture samples and transfer it to an Eppendorf tube. Then, centrifuge the tubes at 1000 G for 10 minutes in order to pellet any cellular debris. The supernatants can be transferred to a new tube and assayed immediately, or they can be stored at negative 80 degrees Celsius for future measurements. One thing to note is that media samples may require being concentrated if the MMPs are very dilute. If your samples are too dilute, one simple and fast way to solve this problem is by concentrating them with centrifugal devices. Click the link below or in the video description to learn more about this technique. When thawing samples that have been stored at negative 80 degrees Celsius, you can either leave them on ice for several hours to melt, or you can thaw them at room temperature and then place them on ice immediately. Just keep checking the tubes every 5 minutes and return them to ice once the media has almost completely thawed out. Again, try not to let them sit at room temperature for more than they need to be. Cells or tissue lysates. If you are obtaining MMPs from cells or tissue lysates, it's important that you use the appropriate ingredients in your lysis buffer. This is because certain ingredients common in other lysis buffers, such as EDTA, can harm the MMPs in your samples and have to be avoided. On our website, we have an example of a lysis buffer that can be used for gelatin zymography and instructions on how to make it. Cell lysates can be obtained using a cell scraper and a small volume of lysis buffer, while tissue samples require different types of homogenization depending on what type of tissue you are working with. Here, I am simply using a needle and a syringe to homogenize some fragile collagen gel samples. Tougher samples might require snap freezing and disruption with other equipment, such as the tissue lyser shown here. It may take a few trials to find the best volume of lysis buffer to use for your samples. Using too little buffer may result in incomplete homogenization. On the other hand, using too much buffer could dilute the MMPs in your samples too much, making them difficult to measure. Be sure to try lysing a few practice samples before making any attempts with precious samples from an experiment. Once your cells or tissue samples have been homogenized, you should measure the total protein content in your samples. One common way of doing this is with a colorimetric protein assay known as the BCA protein assay. On our website, we have a description of how one of these assays can be performed. After measuring the amount of protein in your samples, you'll have to do some algebra to figure out how much additional lysis buffer or water you must add to your samples to bring them to the same total protein concentration. Once you have normalized the concentration of all of your samples can be assayed immediately with gelatin zymography, or they can be frozen at negative 80 degrees Celsius for later assaying. In the next video, we will illustrate the actual steps of gelatin zymography. If you benefited from this tutorial, please click the like button, check out our website, or subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.